Blue sky and snow-covered mountains. That's part of our home in Bavaria. Welcome to Autonotizen International, the English language channel of Autonotizen, which is a German online magazine and YouTube channel. And today I brought to you a car from my home, so to say. A typical Bavarian or even Munich car. This is, as you see, a BMW that also carries a blue and white logo. Here we have the latest 3 Series Touring, which is the name for the station wagon version. It measures 4.71 meters in length and wants to be the sporty, agile, premium, mid-size family station wagon. The test car is equipped with the M Sports trim level, which is the highest trim level available, and the signs for the M Sports model are, for example, a special sporty front bumper, which looks more sporty. We have special alloy wheels. Here on the test car, we have winter tires with 18-inch alloy wheels, and you see blue brake calipers, part of the M Sports braking system. The M logo is also shown here, and everything that's normally chrome, though silver finished, is painted in a glossy black here. BMW calls it shadow line. You see the frame surrounding the windows, for example, they carry this glossy black. Also at the rear we have a special bumper design. You see 2 exhaust pipes here, and here you see the sign 330i. That's the 2-liter 4-cylinder engine with 258 PS or horsepower. But before we try out if the 3 Series 330i is sporty with that 4-cylinder engine, we will try out and see if it's a family car with enough space. And for that, we start with the luggage department. That's a typical detail of BMW Touring models. The rear window can be opened separately, and that's quite more than a gimmick. Imagine you have a small garage, or also outside, if you just have your sports bag or small grocery shopping bag, you can easily put it in here and close the window. But of course, there's a larger gate to the luggage department that opens electrically, and it opens the 500 liters luggage department of the 3 Series Touring. The 3 German premium midsize rivals, namely the Audi A4, the Mercedes-Benz C-Class and the BMW 3 Series, are not known as transportation wonders, but 500 liters is quite okay also for a modern family car. But what's even more impressive is the intelligence of the luggage department. Let's come closer and we have a look to the details. For example, if you want to extend the luggage department with larger stuff, you can electrically fold the rear seat. The maximum size is 1510 liters. You have a cover here that opens, by the way, with the back door. And if you don't need the cover, you can easily store it underneath the floor. There's a second department, and in many competitors it's quite complicated to put it in there, and does it really fit, and where does it fit. Here it's quite easy to do, and then it's stored here, and it's not in the way. There's an additional, a second removable floor that can be adjusted in that position, for example, so you can store stuff here. Here we have the tire fit system, and what you see here is part of German engineering expertise. We have a system that helps to avoid suitcases or other luggage to move around, and there will be air pumped underneath these rubber tubes, and that helps to avoid the luggage to move around in the luggage department. There are various nets to fix smaller items. We have a 12-volt power outlet and a small hook, for example, for a shopping bag that doesn't fall around in the trunk. Let's see how I fit on the rear and front seats of the 3 Series Touring and if it's also a family car in front of the trunk.
My height is 1.92 meters, so I'm quite tall. The driver's seat is in my position, so as I would be sitting there, and at least with the latest BMW 3 Series, I can still find enough space to also sit in the second row. Yeah, it's quite compact, so it shouldn't be any shorter here, but there's almost a finger between my knees and the seat, so that's okay, and I also can put my feet underneath the seat. The back seats themselves are quite comfortable. The headrest is high enough, which is a safety issue, of course. So that's high enough and comfortable. I like them. We have a black roof cover here, part of the M Sports model as well. And here you see the interior, which BMW calls it SensorTech and microfiber. That's also part of the M Sports model, together with the blue stitching lines. We have an armrest here in the middle with two cup holders, and you can also load longer stuff from the trunk, like skis for example, and then you can still travel with the driver and three passengers joining him. The Isofix kids seat system is easily accessible here, and part of the optional air condition control with three climate zones. We have also the third climate zone here in the back, so you can adjust the temperature. And then we have two USB-C power outlets and another 12 volt power outlet. So it's quite comfortable here in the backseat row, and now we move into the cockpit. The core layout of a BMW cockpit looks almost the same for years now, but that's for a reason, because it's very close to perfect indeed. The iDrive control system was launched for the first time back in the year 2001 in the then new BMW 7 Series, and there were a lot of discussions, is that really needed and quite complicated, but so far it proves, of course, there were a lot of improvements over the years, and now it's by far the best system to interact with the machines or the human machine and the interface with the iDrive. You can use the controller by moving it, by pushing it, to let the system do whatever you want. But also, if I, for example, want to insert an address, I can use the writing pad. And it's really hard to make a mistake, so the system understands my handwriting. But now we stop that. And how do I stop that? I can stop it here, of course, by surfing throughout the menu, but also I can use the touch screen, and that came a couple of years ago, that BMW is also introducing the touch screen display. There's a gesture control optional. It's not fitted in here in the test car, luckily, because that's maybe a little bit too much. In addition to that, we have the voice control system. We have a German car here, so I don't want to bother you with German voice control interaction, but I just can show to you how it reacts. Well, we can use a button at the steering wheel, but also we can talk to the car, and you can name the car whatever you want. John, Johnny, Eva, whatever. You first need, of course, to activate the new activation word in the system, and here it's a test car from BMW, and that listens to Hallo BMW.
Hallo, womit kann ich behilflich sein?
And now the system asks what it can do, but also then you can directly start by saying drive me to my home address, drive me to the office, whatever, radio channel, etc. So that works very well, and also the system understands if it's the driver or the co-driver, the passenger, talking. For example, I tried it the other day when I was a passenger, saying I'm cold or I'm hot, and then I can show it to you. That's of course German, but now I will adjust the air condition and the seat heating on my side. Let's have a look. So it's German lesson for you now. Hallo BMW.
Hallo, womit kann ich behilflich sein?
Mir ist kalt.
Oh, ich erhöhe die Temperatur und aktiviere deine Sitzheizung. Gleich wird es wärmer.
So now the seat heating has been activated on my side. I put it off now. And the temperature was increased by 2 degrees Celsius. And yeah, that's not just luxury. It's really helpful when you drive the car. And yeah, the system easily understands what you want to do. This button is also very important. That's the button where I can get full control on all the driving assistance systems. I can put them all on or all off. And here in the test car, we have the driving assistant plus system. So that means we have an adaptive cruise control that of course knows will there be a speed limit in a, let's say, in a kilometer? Will there be any other circumstance? And then you can let the system easily control everything by themselves. I show it to you. We go to here, driving assistant. That's all German now. Speed assistance, and then I can. Yeah, I can choose if the speed limit should be taken automatically by the car to really follow the speed limit, if I want to do it myself. And if I have it here automatically, I can also, maybe that's the typical German way, I can also say it should exceed the speed limit by 10 kilometers per hour or by 8, whatever. Well, that also depends, of course, on the wherever you're watching this video, on the penalties you have in your countries, but you can easily adjust that here. The car is always online, that means real-time traffic information for the navigation system. The voice recognition control needs online connection as well. You can also surf through a list of restaurants nearby and make a choice, and then you can reserve a table there and start the navigation or the route to the restaurant, of course. We have the 8-shift automatic transmission here, but more about that when we are driving. The smartphone can be charged wireless, and we have, in addition to the touchscreen, to the iDrive controller, to the voice control, 8 buttons here, and these buttons can be used to they can be used as your favorite button. You can, for example, program the home address on button 1, the office address at button 2, calling your wife or your husband or girlfriend or whoever, 3, and so on. And then you can just put that button and the car is automatically starting whatever your choice was with that button. So that's also, everything is quite advanced. We have a head-up display as well, that's not easily seeable now with the camera. Full digital display behind the steering wheel. Quite modern, quite nice, and let's see how it drives. Dear car lovers, dear BMW lovers, I know you're all sad that BMW is slowly but surely phasing out the inline six-cylinder engines. My recommendation for you, go to the local dealership, ask for the 330i for a test drive, and then you stop crying. Yes, it's a four-cylinder engine, 2 liters. We have 190 kilowatts of 258 European horsepower PS. And what should I say? It's fun to drive. We are here in the Bavarian Alps region. And yeah, the engine is sporty. The whole car is very agile. We have a perfect response from the steering. Here we have the M Sports model with adaptive dampers. The automatic transmission is in sports mode, and yeah, it feels like a grown-up, very hot hatch. There's enough power, enough torque, 400 newton meters of torque starting
already at 1550 revs per minute, and there's hardly any more that is really needed for fun to drive. On the sport seat, you find the perfect seating position behind the steering wheel. It's a very thick steering wheel. We know that from BMW cars with the sport package or M-Sport package. The 8-speed automatic transmission is doing a perfect job. That's known from this transmission supplied by ZF, a German automotive supplier. You can, if you want, use the pedals behind the steering wheel to do the manual shifting, but you hardly need that because the automatic is doing a perfect job. So does the steering, perfect response from the street. And if you don't want to go the full sporty way all the time, you can use the buttons here in the center console, and you can, for example, as we do now, shift from the sport to the comfort mode. Then we have the Eco Pro, the most efficient mode, and an adaptive mode that comes optional with the adaptive suspension, which is mounted here in the test car. The brochure promises some 6.5 liters of fuel consumption per 100 kilometers. I don't know exactly how much this is in miles per gallon if you're watching in the US. In reality, of course, it's a little bit higher, but still it's quite an efficient car. During the period I had the car, including quick Autobahn, German Autobahn, driving uphill, downhill here, and a lot of commuting, my average fuel consumption is around 9 liters of fuel per 100 kilometers. And for a car like this with 258 horsepower, I think that's still quite efficient. BMW 3 Series has grown in size and format. Finally, it is a family car, enough space in the interior, enough space in the trunk, but still it keeps its agile and sporty compact character. The 330i, in my opinion, is really enough to have fun on the road. Yes, it's a four-cylinder, yes, it's missing these inline six sound, but still, I repeat myself, it's a nice and sporty car. If you have to go long distances, for example with a company car, then you have the 318D or the 320D, the diesel versions. The 320D now comes with a mild hybrid system, which is currently missing in the 330i. It's more agile, more compact, and more cheap than, for example, the BMW 5 Series, which does not mean that it's a cheap car. I have the German price list because we're testing here in Germany. A fully equipped test car, 330i M-Sport package with a full connected drive, infotainment, with head-up display, Harman Kardon sound system, and laser light. This is quite high-tech. Laser light is in addition to the LED high beam, gives more light after or beyond 500 meters of high beam. That costs alone 2,000 euros extra in Germany. So the total car, the test car that you see here, costs 73,000 euros almost, which is of course quite a lot of money, but it is a well thought through and well engineered, well done car. Now we found one more scene to interact with the folding rear window. Thank you very much for watching this video of Autonotizen's international or English speaking channel. I hope you liked it. Thank you very much to Andreas for filming the whole stuff, and I hope that you liked the video. And if you have questions or comments, do so in the comment section. And I would appreciate if you could subscribe to the channel. That will help us. And I hope to see you soon at Autonotizen International. Thank you very much.